Gimbal is an intricate masterpiece of engineering. I like working on complicated things, and gimbal turned out to be one of the most complicated things I have ever worked on.
As opposed to our Arcturus spacecraft, which had a hard-mounted EP thruster, now our EP thruster is mounted onto a gimbal. For Block 2, we decided to design and build our EP gimbal in-house.
So we want to package everything in the smallest possible form factor, and we want to have the smallest mass available. So that kind of drives us to use smallest possible actuators, smallest possible bearings. And during launch, everything shakes and vibrates, and all these delicate mechanisms can get damaged. So a delicate balance that you have to play. It has to survive launch, and then afterwards, it has to operate for almost 10 years without fault in space.
So what the gimbal does is it basically puts a little swivel on our electric thruster, which is the thruster that's used in order to do an orbit raise.
So while the satellite is doing its orbit raise, we are constantly making adjustments of exactly where that ion thruster is pointed. When the ion thruster is fixed to the satellite, we have to actually use fuel to constantly swivel the entire satellite to keep that thruster pointing in the right direction.
As you can imagine, most of the thrusting that we have to do is actually for the orbit rays to get us from our initial elliptical orbit up to geostationary, circular orbit.
We're using more fuel, so the CG of the spacecraft, the center of gravity of the spacecraft, is going to change, and we want to be able to repoint the thruster to most efficiently point through the center of gravity.
In order to avoid having to do corrections with our monopropellant thrusters, because doing corrections with our monopropellant thrusters costs propellant that can cost lifetime.
The amount of fuel you use is directly correlated to the number of years we can successfully operate the satellite on orbit.
Initially, we were looking to buy a gimbal off the shelf, but the quotes we got from big primes were unreasonable, and there are only a few companies in the world that could make a flight-worthy gimbal for geostationary orbits. So we basically faced no choice but to build our own.
With this new gimbal, we can do the same maneuvers with a fraction of the fuel.
So basically, putting this electric propulsion gimbal onto the thruster enabled us to increase our lifetime for providing service.